Happy New Day, everybody! Hello! Happy Tuesday. It's Night Attack Night. It's gonna be a good night. It's gonna be a really good night. I'm Bryce Castillo, your pre-show navigator. Hello. Very excited to have you here with us this Tuesday evening, or watching after the fact on YouTube or Patreon. Hi, thank you. It's very nice of you to join us. It's Tuesday, and that means we're gonna do Night Attack. We're gonna pre-show for about an hour first, so keep an eye out for that. Today on the show, we're gonna have a friend of NSFW hasn't even been on Night Attack. His last appearance on any of these shows was about 5 years ago on NSFW. Is the great Greg Grunberg. He's gonna be amazing. I hope you guys are excited for it. Hopefully he calls it on time. That is gonna be great. And we're gonna be playing it. You know we're gonna be playing it. It's not even playing. We're gonna solve it. We're gonna solve is not right. We did solve last week. But what we're gonna do is of course, the debut of Night Attack Corp. I need an image of Greg to put over this video. Because we got Mike. Mike's great. I love Mike. But it's not Mike. It's Greg Grunberg. Also, that pig died. Bonnie's crazy pigs.
I don't have back legs anymore.
Oh, jeez. But that's coming up on the show tonight, so we're very excited about it. So that's going to be coming up. I hope you guys are excited for it. Stick tuned. I got a little bit of social eating, and I hope you guys will join me on this quest. Oh yeah, 2018. Okay. So Travis, who lives here in Austin, sometimes he finds bizarre and weird foods, and he's like, okay, cool, yeah, I'll get one of these, whatever. So he gave me something. I think this is the first one of his that I've done on the show, but it's like the third one he's given me, so I've got some more. I'm gonna show it to the camera here. I'm gonna show the people watching, and see if what do you think this is, chat. So we've got it's a little longer than my hand, but it's only about a finger and a half wide. It's not very deep. I guess think this is. Ziplonic says a Tootsie Roll. Gentleman Todd says jerky. Alanon says jerky. Aaron Byrne says elk, bison, or camel jerky. A very specific list. Crimson Somebody says poop? No. Kevin Sent says a really thin dick. It would be if that's what it was, I guess. Snake, gator jerky. No, someone got it right, though. Someone got it right. Thank you, Mike TV Live, for the raid. Thank you. Let me get the name. Aphex got it right. This is, of course, Epic Brand. Salmon filet, smoked maple strip. Jerky. It's salmon jerky. This is from Epic. Here are the ingredients. Wild-caught salmon. Maple sugar, organic extra virgin coconut oil, sea salt, onion powder, garlic powder, dill. Contains salmon and coconut. So, oh wow, this is made in... Oh no, it's distributed in Austin. I was going to say, this is made in Austin. You could make jerky in Austin. There's no law. The government says it's okay for you to make jerky in Austin. It's great. So we're going to try. Von Hung Tate says, that's word for bulkiness. I don't believe that to be the case. So we're going to... I'm going to try and open this thing up. It's kind of a fucking thing to get it open, though.
Hold on.
They canceled HQ tonight? Oh, I wonder if the negotiations with Mike Wazowski went down. That's crazy. All right, here we go. We're gonna open it. It's really gonna open, I swear to God. This fucking thing doesn't want to open. God. This is great. This is great content for the channel. I could get a knife, but then I have to abandon you people. Okay, hold on. Oh, okay, here we go. We've got the bartender. I believe we still have these at scamstuff.com. Get them at Black Friday. Black Friday, everything's going to be on sale. It's going to be great. And one of the things in here is a knife, a nice size knife. Oh, this one's a little bit dirty because it's been used before. There we go. Look at that. Nice clean cut, nice hefty blade, and just goes right back in. Scamstuff.com. We're gonna try. Jen of Top had a saying, rip fingers. I know how to use a knife. I'm good. Oh, here we go. All right. So, it reminds me of like dog treats. Like not dog food, but like dog treats. I guess that's just like a natural part of the jerky process. So, it's here, we got a little bit of a visual of it. It's almost completely opaque. It's almost completely opaque. Okay. Well, we're gonna try it. Funkyria says don't eat it. I'm gonna eat it. It's gonna be fine. Here we go. Off a piece so that other people can try it. Here we go. Isoplonic says he's betting on puke. No. You know, I get the salmon taste. I get like a hint of it. I don't love. Here's the thing I don't love. I don't love the consistency of it. It's a little. It's less dry than I expected. I was kind of almost expecting like a. Like an overcooked like bacon sort of thing when you cook bacon really long. I like that where it's just like it turns into like a leaf where you just so the consistency thing I think is just the big problem for me. I'm gonna try another bite. Oh, this one's a little bit larger. This one is about a little bigger than a thumbnail. Apex says, is it leathery? I suspect this is what leather would taste like. If I ate my little Diamond Club leatherette, my little leather keychain, that's what I expect the polished side to maybe taste like. I'm also not loving the juice factor. It's kind of making my gag reflex activate just a little bit. So you're just joining us. This is Epic Brands Salmon Filet Smoked Maple Strip Jerky. Okay. This was a big bite. This was a very big bite. So I'm gonna have Brian try a little bit of this because he loves jerky. And he eats jerky all the time. And I wonder if it's on his keto or not keto, whatever his like. Well, no, because he's doing like a all beans thing right now. Gentleman Top Hat asks, Neshcom, have you ever eaten Bean Boozled beans? No, is that like the Birdie Bots thing? I have to take this like a little bit at a time. Oh boy, man. I literally bit off more than I could chew. Just, it's the consistency. It's not a great consistency. I would either want it to be firmer or looser. Okay. I think I'm done with this bite. Okay. Gentleman Top Hat says, yes, it is like the Birdie Bot thing. Okay. I never tried those as a kid because I was kind of scared of them being bad, you know? Scandrel says, off topic, how are the TCL monitors? So we've got, here in the studio, we have multiple monitors here. Here we go. And take, and cue, and take. And this monitor here is our newest one, and it is a TCL with the Roku TV stuff built in. Brian uses it more than I do, because he and the family will actually watch stuff in here. I think like this is where they'll watch like Game of Thrones and stuff, so that the kids can't hear it. I am glad to be done eating this jerky for tonight. And he just raves about it. He has nothing but nice things to say. And I think it looks good. I think it looks pretty good. And my understanding is that it was pretty cheap. So, you know, you can't go wrong with, you know, Chinese TCL monitors, I'm sure. Oh, that. Kevin Sense says salmon jerky with an Angry Orchard chaser, which is what I'm drinking. I'm drinking Angry Orchard, crisp apple tonight. Is a disrespect to good cider. Gentleman Top Hat says Bean Boozled is even worse. All right, I'm gonna look this up then. Bean Boozled. This isn't the Diamond Jim Tyler series of magic books, is it? Because those are called Bamboozlers. All right, let's see. Oh, they're made by Jelly Belly. Download the free Bean Boozled app. Okay, so yeah, it is literally just the Birdie Bots, right? Like, so the brown one, maybe it's chocolate pudding, maybe it's canned dog food, maybe the yellow one is buttered popcorn or rotten egg. Yeah, it's just Birdie Bots. And it's cool. Oop, don't do that. It's cool, but ugh. Kevin Sense says Bernie Bots is my radio name when I did a weekend in Nantucket. Okay. So happy Tuesday, everybody. That salmon jerky is not what I expected. So I haven't really had like a lot of jerky. I would be interested to try just regular jerky and see how it compares, because the consistency on this was really unappealing. This would be something I would have to eat in like super small bites, because it's got a juice factor, it's got a consistency factor. I almost thought when I bit into it that I would like it if it had been in the fridge for like 30 minutes or an hour, right? Like, I think I might have liked it if it was cold or a little harder. But at room temperature, it was not super great. So we'll see. Maybe Brian, like, we'll get the expert opinion from Brian. So that's social media. Gentleman Top Hat says Bean Boozled has skunk spray beans? What are skunk spray beans? That sounds awful. Why would you? That sounds like a fucking YouTuber thing. Like, when I Googled it, the very top result here from the not ad ones is a Bean Boozled Challenge, the Jelly Belly Candy Company. Like, this is just like a bit.
I don't know how much I feel about that.
So, that's that. I'm going to put that away. I'm going to put the fantastic bartender, probably still available at scamstuff.com, over here. Max Shaw says, get Bonnie to try the jerky. We'll see. We'll see. There's plenty to go around. Ugh. What else is going on? Okay, let's do this. So some people were talking about Chrome and Firefox. So when we were doing weird things yesterday, and I had some batteries charging up here in the studio. Apparently, the studio is riding the line on the circuit breaker, and I think those extra batteries that we're charging tipped it over, and we lost power just in this room. And when we came back up, we had the new Firefox installed. You can see it here. It's got, like, I turned it on when the computer came back up. It like tried to restore the window automatically. So when this page I had not seen, because we were in the middle of weird things, and so I only have to look at everything anyway. And it's like this new top bar, and everything's weird. I like, did I just get? Is this Chrome or not Chrome? Like Edge? Is this Microsoft Edge that I'm using? What am I using now? But I will say, it was pretty snappy. You know, opening and loading tabs seems, and closing tab, especially. Oh boy, I'm getting the barbs. It's especially feels snappier. That's what I'll say, is that it feels snappier. I don't really know. You know. I don't really know. Maybe it's not. Maybe it's all. Maybe it's all just fake. Like, I think it would be fine to just be fake, right? But I don't know. Oh yeah, they really did not do HQ tonight. That's so weird. Like, they've missed afternoon games before, but they didn't. They haven't missed an evening game. Sorry, that's. Anyway. Someone says you'll buy the whole web browser, but you only need the Edge. It kind of got us talking a little bit. We shot something a little bit right before this for Black Friday coming up at GameStuff.com and shop.themodernroom.com. And we were talking about the Firefox, the new Firefox thing, and I think we were actually initially talking about Microsoft Edge, because, like, Internet Explorer has this horrible image, right? So at some point you just have to say, fuck it, we're just doing a new name. It's a new name! It's called Edge! And so it got us thinking about the days of, like, a ton of different web browsers, when there is, like, the one I could especially remember having used was Avant, because it was one of the first ones with tab browsing. It had tabs, and that was a big thing. It's weird to feel. It's weird to remember back when tabs were like the hot new thing. And then Firefox and Chrome, you know, dominated. So I had a before Android really took off, I had a Samsung. Oh, what was it called? I don't even remember the name of it, but it was a Samsung touchscreen phone. But it was capacitive. I believe it was capacitive touchscreen. Or no, it wasn't. It was pressure, which is the one that's pressure. It was a pressure touchscreen. And one of the very few apps that you could get for it that was not, like, buying a, like, some weird universe, some Symbian OS version of Tetris, was a beta of Opera. And that was pretty cool. That worked pretty well. But it was still like this weird thing of, like, you're using this third-party app to get to Opera. I don't know. It was resistive, yes. But it was like an Opera beta and I think it had tabs. It was, man, that phone, I kind of, was it an, no, I, part of me said, oh, it's a Samsung Edge, which is fucking not what, definitely not what it was called, or nothing I would be able to find, but it was one of the, I don't know, it was a cell phone. Where are the boys? I need girls' generation here to bring the heat. Bring the boys out. But yeah, I mostly use Chrome because I actually don't use it as my mobile browser, but mostly I don't use it. But I do like being able to sync bookmarks and stuff. That's pretty nice. And this new Firefox stuff, it's cool, but it also does some weird stuff. Like, I think maybe this is the way that this computer is set up, but on here, like, it had built-in Pocket integration and, like, you know, the I know that definitely does this, is that your new blank page, your blank new tab screen, right, instead of being like, this is kind of what it should have looked like in the past, but now they've got like recommended stories and highlights of like stuff I've looked at, and it's like, nah, I just need my most recent stuff and a search bar. Maybe not even that. Yeah. That's your browser. Minute. Here's the pre-show. Hey, it's Brian Brushwood. Yo.
Yo. Yo. Yo.
How you doing?
Man.
Yeah?
I'm happier than a puppy with two Peters.
Oh.
I don't know exactly how happy a two-dick dog is, but I would imagine...
I don't know that it has the relative...
But, plus, also, it hasn't hit dog puberty, so it's like it doesn't even know what to do with it. I think what I'm expressing is I'm happy being ignorant in youth.
Okay. But it's a good day today. Let's see if Justin's around. He's online on Skype.
We have to craft the perfect tweet to explain how majestic this evening is going to be.
We do. Okay. Yeah,
Normally, I take on the responsibility myself, but I'm willing to say that my talents alone are not enough to get us where we need to be. Because you realize how epic this is. We're on the front page of Twitch. Mm-hmm. We have
a huge
all-star, genuine LA celebrity guest.
Yeah.
Have we announced? Have we said?
Yes, we have.
Okay.
TV and film.
Star Wars' own. Star Wars'
Wars.
He's the Star Warser. Let's call him the Star Warser.
I'm sure he'll love that.
We also have a bit that you've been working on, I think, over a year now.
No,
I'm pretty sure you've worked on this over 1 year.
I looked at the timestamps because it's the sort of thing where, like, we got some when we first announced it, and then we got some today.
Yeah.
And it was like 3 months we've been talking about it.
Mm.
We have a really good bit with Night Attack Court. It's gonna be pretty good. And it's funny, I guess what I'm saying,
like this is the best time. For us to put on our best tweet game and tweet twat the Jeep job.
Yeah, well, hey, everybody, let your friends know. Twitch.tv/nightattack is where we're at tonight. Hi, Justin.
Yeah, if you thought we were somewhere else, fuck you.
No.
Yeah, you know what? Let's just make our new slogan, fuck you. Fuck you. Hey.
Hold on. Only if we didn't. If they didn't know where we were.
Right. They have to. If they know where we are, they're
also
cool, my book.
If you do know where we are, fuck you.
Oh.
Fuck you.
That's a wrinkle that they don't know until they get here.
And then when they get there, what do they get? They open up the door.
Fuck you.
And then it's like, but wait, that was irony.
Brian. So I feel like, of the people I know, you know Jerky really well.
Oh, my God. Yeah, I know Jerky. Also, am I looking at a video of Jerky right now? Celebrate Greg Grunberg on Night Attack. Holy shit, look at this video.
Okay, well then I will...
It's in the chat. The thing I was setting. My god.
Okay, well, while Brian's reacting, let's all watch it. How about that?
We are the party in Greg Grunberg's crotch.
Oh no, this is the Chips. This is Chips doing Celebrate. Remember this? We watched this.
Yeah, this is.
Oh shit, that's right.
Celebrate.
It's over his crotch. What is he on? An airplane with his shirt off?
I don't know.
I see you. I don't know why you make so many songs. Thank you, I see you.
Well, anyway, we're the best in the business. Brian's watching the videos privately and laughing. I'm eating his apple right into the mic. Look, nobody knows how to podcast like us. Fuck you if you fucking don't.
Nailed it.
All right, Brian. So I tried this out a little bit earlier. I didn't bite into it, so you are welcome to have some. I mentioned this a while ago. I don't know if you remember it. Travis here in town gave me smoked salmon filet jerky.
Oh my god, I'm gonna love it. Are you kidding me?
I don't know.
You did not love this immediately?
So I'm not a big jerky person, and I did.
All right, first of all, you'll notice that they did a great job of drawing a picture of a salmon that I would not be confused as to what this meat is. Because if you gave me this, I would think, like, that looks like donkey dick. But aha, it's not. It's a salmon.
It's a salmon, right.
So I'm just gonna squeeze this up to the top. Salmon jerky is different from... Ooh, dear, that smell.
Yeah, it's kind of got a smell, huh? And I don't know that the consistency is right. I need to know from you if the consistency
is
right.
This is straight up salmon.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's salmon and like honey... I think... look in the ingredients. There's like a honey or cinnamon...
Salmon, maple sugar, organic maple sugar. Extra virgin... coconut oil, sea salt, onion powder, garlic powder, dill. Also, wild caught salmon, not farmed salmon.
Oh, that's the good stuff.
Yeah, listen, you ever bit into a salmon and you spit it right out? Like, fucking, this tastes of slavery.
For the record, like, reading those words, I am already primed to think this is the best thing I've ever eaten in my entire life.
Oh, wow. Please enjoy a bit.
Yeah, here we go.
Here he goes. He's taking the bite.
You know that show Hot Ones? They're really good. That really great series, Hot Ones, where they do the interviews with the chicken wings.
Oh yeah. With the hotter and hotter sauce.
Hot sauces. Let's do our own. We get a jerky sponsor. We call it Jerk Offs.
Yeah, let's jerk off, boys.
Yeah, exactly. This is the Jerk Off, and we do. PR approved questions in between different jerkies.
Mind me, I'm just shoving this meat in my mouth.
Is it good?
I love it when my tongue runs around this meat. Mm.
Is it good? I mean, you continue eating it. I can't assume it's anything
it's
other
fucking
than
fucking great.
Really?
Did you have a problem with this?
Well, so
I'm sorry. Do I have a problem with you? Have I misjudged our friendship?
No. So I told you I haven't had a lot of jerky before. How, on a consistency scale, like mouthfeel, does that bite into like jerky would? Because I thought it was kind of loose.
Nothing worse than loose jerky.
All right.
I will say it is a little bit... One of the things I like about jerky is that it's always different, depending on how long it's been around or what piece of chunk of meat. Mm. My favorite jerky is the one that feels like somebody just yanked off a shoulder and hold it up to the sun for 20 minutes and it just jerkified and then they set it in my hand.
Uh-huh.
This feels a little bit overly processed.
Interesting.
Fucking take down that score. The salmon jerky was living a little high on the hog.
Take that, Epic Brand.
However,
jerky.
I don't know the challenge. I don't know, like, I don't know how hard it is to make jerky out of salmon, like, but I would love it more if it looked like a fillet that was just held up to the sun.
Okay. You know what I mean? Because it's pretty square and machined almost.
A little bit too close to the dog treats.
That part of the jerky.
Right?
It smells like a dog treat.
It's too consistent with dog treats. Tastes great, though.
Wow.
You a big salmon man, Justin?
Yeah, are you salmon man? Is there a reason that all of your fraternity buddies called you Justin Salmonman?
You know, a lot, because I was always swimming upstream. You know, against the grain, you know, whenever anybody would say, stop doing that, I'd say, nope, I'm doing it, which is why I'm resigning from Disney.
Stop doing that.
You sure are the...
Wait. Ooh, it's me, the ghost of 24-hour references. resigned as fast as John Lasseter.
Wait, I don't even know about this reference. Talk me through it.
John Lasseter is a creep, and apparently, and now he's leaving Disney. Ooh.
Wait, for reals?
He's going on like a hiatus.
Man, this is a minefield.
Too many pussies hiatus. Ooh.
This is a minefield I do not want to waltz into. However, let me just ask, is there any end to this? Is this just the new age? Is anybody accuses everyone of everything? And again, let's assume everybody's guilty. But
he admitted. He admitted it.
Yeah,
voluntarily
he was like, yeah, I did it.
He
My
accused
bad.
Himself.
Yeah.
He's like, ha ha. You can't get me if I get myself. I got myself. I'm number one. John Lasseter. And he flies to space.
Yeah.
All right.
It's working out well for... Yeah.
For President Trump?
Yeah. Yeah, hey. Man. I don't know. It's,
Hey, all right. That's a great topic, man. We're sizzling hot right now, everybody. Sizzling.
So sizzling, let's go to Sizzler.
We're gonna go to Sizzler, man. Hey, what was your favorite thing on in the salad buffet at Sizzler? Bryce.
The salad buffet of Sizzler. I don't think I've ever eaten at a Sizzler.
What's your okay, hey, way to keep the conversation going.
I've never
all right. Ryan, go. Salad buffet at Sizzler. Where you at?
Fuck you, Golden Corral or bust.
Golden Corral.
That's
baby,
where
yeah.
I gotta fill my veins with fat.
Oh, the fish is coming. Yo, are you good? Whoa, he fucking really fell.
I tried to sell the bit. I scared Bryce.
You did.
Sorry.
You did.
The thing about Sizzler and Ponderosa, you know, they do a different thing. Golden Corral, everything's on the buffet. Sizzler and Ponderosa, you only got to order one thing. You're worrying about that steak. You say, all right, I'm going to order this steak, but then everything else, that's buffet town, baby. I mean, Golden Corral, Jesus, you're going to lower the quality of everything out here. Oh, yeah, sure. Here's some shrimp. Here's a Fabergé egg. They promise you the world there at the Golden Corral.
It's been a hot minute. Oh, you know, it equally is Old Country Buffet. If you needed your cheaper regional Golden Corral, it was Old Country Buffet.
Yeah.
But I remember.
Hey, do they also do the you just order a steak and then you get the other shit?
No, I think it was all buffet there too.
See, get that fucking right out of my face. I don't need any. I don't know. I mean, just you know how much this is an unreasonable proposition, right? Like you're just buying, you're getting a bill of goods here.
I mean, steak is not good for the buffet format.
Hold on.
Well, I don't.
This is spoken like somebody who hasn't visited enough Las Vegas buffets.
Okay.
Like when you walk up, that's my favorite part of the buffets, is it's all just cold, lifeless flesh for you to grab. But then you encounter a human being who looks you in the eyes and says, are you ready?
Well, that's
how
what I'm
much
saying.
Do you want? But, and they look you in the eyes. They cut the flesh. They look right at you.
Okay.
They look right at you. And then uh-huh. they peel it onto your plate. And then they pause and then they go,
do you are? Right.
And then yeah. you not knowing what to say, don't react, and so you just wide eyed stare like a doe eyed beautiful doe.
Doe.
And then they cut even more, and you think, oh, I shouldn't. This is.
But they're already right. cutting. But
it's too late. They've already cut.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying is that you wouldn't want it. You can't treat steak like a chicken breast. Right, you can't just have it in a pan.
I could treat steak like a chicken breast.
Okay, wait.
I could cuddle up with a steak and watch a movie.
There is an Allman Brothers song called "You Can't Treat Steak Like a Chicken Breast." Can't treat steak like a chicken breast. Can't treat pants like a country dress. You can't go to court if you don't have a case, and you need to smack your butt if you're wearing that lace.
All right. Yeah.
You don't spit in a chicken breast eye. You don't tell Wonder Woman who's fly.
In a breast eye.
Mike TV remembers that song.
Kevin Sen says you used to be able to treat steak like a chicken breast, but now it's frowned upon.
Yeah, hashtag MAGA.
No, hold on. Oh, damn it. Someone put a water tag on the Monday Night Football theme. Let's pretend we're doing this for 1 second.
Oh, no.
Let's pretend that we're doing this for 1 second. I agree. That was the original title of this show. I said, I have a show, Justin. It's called Let's Pretend We're Doing This for 1 Second.
Yeah, what was the pitch for? Was it the same show, or was it maybe a different show?
Oh no! It was a totally different show. There were four robot sidekicks, and
hold on, wait a minute. This is a fucking great idea. Has anyone done steak nuggets? On the subject of trying to treat steak like a chicken breast, has anyone done steak nuggets?
I mean, steakums are as close as you get. Steak fingers.
Is it a major upset that no fast food restaurant has been like, you've wanted it forever. Fucking steak nuggets! And made a big
and
deal
they,
about
they
it.
They actually curse during it. They say fucking steak
fucking
nuggets.
Steak nuggets. Fucking steak! And it's like, it's Carl's Jr., but he's like fucking in that big hat. Like, he's just, you know.
So like
is that Carl's Jr., the fucking crazy head man?
Crazy head man.
Are you thinking of Arby's with the big cowboy hat?
No, the big old white head.
No, that's Jack in the Box.
That's Jack in the Box.
Jack in the Box.
Yeah, no, he'd be like, hey, it's me, the Jack in the Box guy. You're ready to have a great meal, aren't you, at a good price? That's my promise to you. Get some fucking steak nuggets!
So, like, this is a photo from norecipes.com of a steak, chicken fried steak nuggets.
I mean, that's the thing. It's like if you go, you know, and maybe this is the smart thing is they figure don't fight them on nugget territory. Chickens already own nugget territory. Instead, fight them where they're not fighting. You don't chicken fry the nugget. You chicken fry the whole fucking steak.
Right. Chicken fried steak.
Exactly. Well, I'm saying we got to push this. Who do we got to call? Who do we got to call a Jack in the Box?
Do me a favor. Google search Larry Steaks.
Here we go. Larry.
Whoever it is, let's just reach out to Larry Steaks.
Sure.
Larry's Steaks. There it is, right up top. What's the phone number?
Let's go ahead and cold call him and put him live on the air.
What's the phone number? Call Larry's Steaks and ask if they have steak nuggets. Call them. We've got the number right there. Call Larry's Steaks. Larry's Steaks. Just give him a call. Just press that button.
Right, we're right in the line. We're right in that Hank Williams Jr. line.
It's good. It's good. We just want to know. I've heard a rumor. Somebody said on the internet that Larry Steaks had steak nuggets, and you, I assume, would love to have them.
Okay. Are you going to talk to the people at Larry Steaks?
I mean, sure. Okay. As long as you're the one talking.
No! I can't do
it. Wait, remember that one time, Bryce, when we made you talk to those people that might be Hail Bop?
I do remember that. Remember that one, yeah.
That was a great time.
All right, just get him on the line. Let's see what we got.
Okay.
Larry.
Hey, I heard on the internet that you guys do steak nuggets. Is that true?
Steak nuggets?
Yeah, man. Like deep fried nuggets, like chicken nuggets, only they're made with steaks. I heard they're delicious.
No, we don't do that. I wish.
Why? Oh, yeah. So you're with me. You wish they would do that.
I wish I did.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Bye.
Never surrender.
Oh, my God. All right. Headline.
Okay.
Even Larry's Steaks wishes Larry's Steaks had nuggets.
That'll be Vox.com. Why Larry Steak wants steak nuggets, too.
Oh, my God.
Steak nuggets, man. Steak nuggets are a cause we can get behind.
Yeah, man. I think we can all get behind it.
Everybody start hashtagging steak nuggets. I want to start a national conversation.
Hit up Larry's Steaks, man.
Larry's Steaks. Can we throw our hat over the wall in a promise that will almost surely be forgotten even by the time this show begins in 20 minutes?
Sure. Yeah, no, I'll commit my life to this. Also, what is it?
Let's find a place that'll do steak nuggets for South By.
Oh, my God. Yeah, yes, between now and South By. This has to be our one rallying cry. Steak nuggets needs to be a thing. Let's find out.
Let's fucking tweet every restaurant in Austin whether or not they will commit to steak nuggets.
Okay, between now and South By, the question just has to be, everybody call anybody in Austin and just say, do you do steak nuggets?
Just hit up the 512 area code.
I heard it was a thing. I'm really hoping to have some steak nuggets. And then they're like, what are steak nuggets? They're like, they're nuggets, like chicken nuggets of steak.
But with steak.
Yeah.
Dude, all right. Oh, wait. Fucking Kennedy offered to put pledged to put a man on the moon.
He made an offer to put a man on the moon. In that famous speech, Kennedy said, I don't know if you're doing anything, but I just say it, like, I got a place. I mean, if you wanted to, I suppose you could go to the moon. And I could take you there. I'm just saying. I'm not. It's not for me to. But I mean, if you want to go, I mean, the moon's right there. It's 1969. I'm dead.
He's appeared from out of a wall like the fucking Frighteners.
Yes.
This is the sequel to 11/22/63.
Everyone, let's get a few things straight, okay? Don't fucking tell me you're gonna make steak muggets and then fucking tell me and then show me some cubed ass steak. I'm not fucking here for that. Get that shit right the fuck out of here.
Yeah, this looks like some teriyaki.
That shit ain't deep fried. That shit is not slammed into the shape of the handle, the anvil, the star, the hammer, and the stirrup.
Will you commit to steak nuggets by March? Ask any restaurant in Austin. We will patronize them. We will make this a big fucking deal for Diamond Club fandom, which comes to Austin in fucking droves for that interactive weekend.
That's what we do, is we make it clear. Like if you want all of our business, we are a cabal. We are the demon fiery hordes of the internet, and we want one thing, and that's steak nuggets. And if you're going to turn to us and ask, what are steak nuggets? Hey, fuck you. If you have to ask, you're not qualified. Why don't you fucking figure out what they are,
you can't afford
them, make them, and have them available in time for South by Southwest.
So we're only asking something very simple.
Very simple. Very simple.
Offer on your menu steak nuggets by March. Also, A1 dipping sauce, of fucking course, another mech in the chat.
No, hey, fuck you with your A1. I want to be able to dip in a straight-up whoosh. I want a straight-up whoosh a Jew.
Worcestershire.
Oh, shit. A Jew. A Jew.
A Jew. Bless you.
Gesundheit.
Gesundheit.
So just to get it clear, the pitch that we're going to make to these venues for South by Southwest in Austin, Texas, will be you have to have steak fingers or we won't come.
No. We will make a big night of it, either probably Thursday or Friday night, right? Where we will direct at least 10 people to their restaurant.
I mean, no, you know what? Let's not talk about the low end. Let's say no more than 1,000.
No more.
No more. Don't worry. There'll be no more than 1,000. Okay. Guaranteed it.
No, these nugs are battered. These are chicken nuggets, but with steak instead of chicken.
Oh, my gosh. Well, look forward to that, everybody, in March.
Coming this spring. Q1. 2018, yeah. Steak nuggets.
Get your hopes up. Hold your breath on this one, people.
Hold your breath. Hold your breath.
No, listen. I want, like, let's fucking blanket Austin's Twitter tonight. Every Austin restaurant that you can think of.
By the way, there's also a Austin subreddit. We should go to austin.reddit.com and start up like, yo, where are the good steak nugs at? Steak nugs. Steak nugs. Two syllables. Two syllables instead of steak four. Chicken nuggets. I don't have time for that. I want steak nugs. 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 Steak nugs.
Oh, my God. I'm fucking Ben Franklin. Get raise up off my nuts with this.
He's on your nuts?
Abomination.
Oh, what's up?
Wait, he's what? Fucking saying that I should be ashamed for fucking championing the cause of steak nugs.
Bullshit! That motherfucker should stop flying kites in thunderstorms. He done electrified his brains. That's his problem. Between that and the syphilis, I don't know. I don't trust him anymore.
And trying to get fucking old women to fucking slob on his knob?
Oh, well, I mean, specifically, I think he liked to take them from behind. I think his point was that from behind, bent over, 90 looked like 40.
Nice. If he's gonna bust it wide open,
I mean, you know, that's up to him. Steak nugs, steak nugs, steak nugs.
No, I think this is maybe the greatest cause we've ever gotten behind. I mean, I'm just shocked that no one's done it, right?
I wonder what cut of
alcoholic steak nugs.
Now it's alcoholic.
Yeah, no, marinate them in wine.
No. Come on, Brian. We got to be reasonable here. We're not fucking. I mean, you can. All right,
fine. Steak nugs. Cocaine braised nugs. Steak nugs.
Mm-hmm. You thought that was the good direction.
Dust cocaine, and then you take a blowtorch, and you caramelize it, and then you just bite it, and you
caramelize the cocaine.
Yeah,
we got to be like a nice cocaine. We gotta have a nice little crunch on top of it.
Right. Mm.
Cocaine.
That crunch scrunch.
Caramelizes.
That's where you take. Yeah, oh, man. The crunch scrunch you get. That's where you punch a hole in it and use it to tie a ponytail. And then somebody sniffs the cocaine off the top.
But they scrunch up their face because they don't
like it. Mike TV points out that is literally free basing.
Oops.
Hey, man. Uh-oh. Yeah. We want the idea to be free for everybody. We're not claiming copyright trademarks. Just, you know.
Yeah. People are like, oh, this is open source. Well, I'm freebasing.
Yeah,
so.
Open source? We got plenty of those. We're freebasing cocaine off of steak nugs. So, yeah, we have open source.
And we're being environmentally conscious. We're sharing utensils. Like forks and knives and needles.
See, I think we're all on the same page here, man. Let's all get naked and freebase cocaine off of steak nugs and share them.
It's a fair point, Brian. You know, a lot of people don't really realize how similar this is to doing cocaine.
Cool. Yeah, it sounds like doing cocaine while eating a cut of someone having cut up a steak for you.
You know what? Let's do that instead. Let's just all do cocaine all right,
so
while somebody cuts steak.
Call the tweet the Austin restaurants and see if they accept
Hold
cocaine.
On. What other Austin restaurants are there?
I am dead serious about this steak nugs thing. We got to at least get denials. We have to at least put people on the record saying that they do not offer steak nugs, nor will they offer them when we come to Austin.
Call Fogo de Chow. Call Fogo de Chow.
Okay.
There it is.
I hope I spelled it right.
C-H-A-O. There it is. Yeah. Fogo de Chow. There you go. We're going to give him a call, and we'll ask.
Here we go. We're going to go to the dialer.
You know what? I'm going to dial it up. I'm going to set them up for a win here.
Okay. Oh, da-da-da-da-da. All right. Here we go. Calling Fogo de Chow.
The gang goes to jail.
Shut up.
Good
evening. Thank you for calling Fogadich Home. This is Christina speaking. How may I help you?
Hey, Christina. I've got a giant event. We're looking at 100 to 200 people coming up. It'll be in 3 or 4 months. They have a weird request, though. We're looking for somebody who can accommodate an unusual request. Everybody wants steak nuggets. Basically, deep-fried chunks of steak, just like chicken nuggets, but with steak. Is that something you guys could provide?
For how many people did you say?
I would say conservatively 50, but realistically 50. Closely to 80 to 100. And we all want to be at your place at one time.
Okay. Could I put you on hold and ask them?
Yeah, of course. That'd be great.
Okay. Thank you.
Hashtag MAGA.
Stop it! God, we're gonna get steak nuggets. I'm so excited.
Okay, sir, we can't do that.
You can't?
Yes, we can't.
We haven't even gotten to the part where we talk price. Like, is there some number at which it becomes worth it for you?
No, we just don't do that at all.
I mean, this is kind of a long-running bit among our crowd. And I feel like I feel like we can get some pretty good money together to make this happen. Like, I mean, I know you don't want to say a number, but if you just whispered a number, then I might be able to blink twice to say yes.
Okay, do you want to speak to the manager?
Yes, there we go. Now you're talking my language. Okay. Let's do that.
Okay. Could I put you on hold?
Of course.
Okay.
Tricky voice.
Oh, Matula points out that they probably don't have deep fried.
Thanks for holding. How can I help you?
Hi, my name is Brian. What was your name?
Roberto.
Roberto. Hey, Roberto. So here's the thing. Every year for 7 years running, we have a big get together close to South by Southwest time. We've got a passionate and strange fan base. And for whatever reason, it's gotten into our heads that nobody makes steak nuggets. And we're thinking, we're looking at, you know, 50 to 150 of us showing up at South by Southwest. What would it take for us to have you guys make us steak nuggets that we could all eat?
For 100 people?
Yeah.
They
could be pan fried. They don't have to be deep fried. Just something that resembles chicken nuggets, but they're better because they're made of steak. And when we thought of steaks, we thought of Fogo de Chao.
Mm-hmm. So I have... How do you want it? Just cubes of meat?
Oh, yeah. No, cubes of meat would be perfect.
Yeah, but it's not going to come out good.
Oh, that's fine. None of us are concerned about how good they are. We just want somebody who would dare to do the impossible. We assume that there's some reason that steak nuggets have never caught on, and we look forward to experiencing the reason why.
Mm-hmm. So... for that, you need to talk to the sales manager and see what she can do for you. But she's going to be here only Monday now.
Monday? Only Monday?
Yeah. Friday. I think I'm not sure if she's coming Friday.
Okay.
But if you want to try to call her Friday... 9:30, if she's coming, she's going to be here.
But I mean, you guys do catered events, and you I assume, are able to cater to specific dietary demands, right?
No, we really don't do catering.
You don't do catering, but you do host private events?
Yes.
Okay, So, like, if 100 of us showed up and you knew that the one dish all of us wanted was some kind of steak cube, deep fried, looking and feeling like a nugget, I mean, you could, come on, man. I mean, just bro to bro, you could make that happen, right?
Yeah, I think we can do that.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. All right, good. Who should I'm going to have my people give you a call. What's the best person for me to have them call?
Yeah, her name is Laura.
Laura. Okay. Yeah. All right. You got it. All right. Thank you very much. We'll see you in 3 months.
Okay, I'll see you.
All right, bye. Come on.
Incredible.
Come on.
Hold on.
Come on.
Holy shit. That was fucking amazing. That was the negotiation, the way that negotiations used to be done.
The negotiation, of course, being like, oh, you don't do it? Yeah, but I think you want to do it, don't you? And then repeat until you win.
Holy shit. Man, I feel like this is going to happen. We're going to do a fucking steak nugs thing. I'm shocked. It took my butt and it blew it out my ass, man. That fucking call.
All right, right on. Good.
Kevin Sense coming to South By this year. By the way, South By is going to be rad because I think I'm going to do a politics live. And, of course, we're going to do Night Attack.
Can I play
awesome.
Second fiddle during politics?
You can do whatever you want.
God, I love it. I love being there.
Also, by the way, you'll be a lot easier to wrangle than fucking O'Doctor, who was on politics live fucking this Saturday.
Oh,
in
shit.
Philly.
Oh, did he take over the whole show?
He's fucking O'Doctor. Literally, he was 5 minutes in and he was telling me to continue on talking. Like, he would go on his O'Doctor rants and just be like, well, what I'm about to say, and I didn't know the answer, but continue.
O'Doctor does not sound like Bo Bama, though. Yeah, that's definitely Bo Bama.
I will say, I challenge you to listen to the show.
All right, that's true. I haven't listened yet.
I did pop it on after yesterday's cue on After Things, and I enjoyed what I heard of it.
Wait, the live show?
Yeah, the PAX How to Lose 40K.
Oh, that was another thing. That was the PAX talk, and then we did PX3 live the next night.
All right.
That'll be out tomorrow, so everybody will be able to find out how racist I am.
Man, I think I got this feeling. It started in my cloaca, and it started up my vagus nerve, and it went all the way through my scapulas into my trapezoidal detritus. And now I feel like we're on the front page of Twitch.
We are.
I don't know. Yeah. I feel like
my butthole tightened. Like that.
That was
like
on me. I tightened your butthole. I found the controls to your butthole, and I twisted it all the way to 11. That's why you felt that way.
Yeah, so that's me showing how tight my butthole is.
And then us loading up the front page of Twitch.
That's great. Hey, Bryce, can you open up another screen over that screen where you also do the same thing?
Absolutely, I can.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
Twitch.tv. We'll just go to twitch.tv.com.
Yeah, we're just going to get to the front page.
You know,
gonna be
four or five more. Oh, look. Hey, there we are.
Hey, that's us.
That's not going to be confusing for anybody tuning in live now.
This will be definitely compelling content.
Oh, my gosh. They're going to be like, they're people just like me who look at their own channel, looking at their own channel, looking at their own channel, looking at their own channel. God,
this is actually, I should not have done that edible.
Because it's not fast enough where you like get the hallway effect immediately. Like
you get like the 1987 286 drawing each room of your RPG that you're playing.
Yeah,
you get the pool of radiance effect.
Yeah, no, just keep that there every once in a while.
This is great. No, everybody's going to instantly get it. They're like, I don't know who these guys are, but they understand. Good Twitch.
Technology is amazing. Oh, look, there's four of them.
Good. Fucking eat that, Hyper RPG. You don't fucking, you waste this front page real estate. We're doing real fucking work here.
See, now you're doing it. Now you're doing it right.
Exactly.
Oh, goddamn.
Excellent.
Justin, do you realize how dumb we are? We've gotten to ourselves in a place where we've established relationships with friends who were in fucking Star Wars movies, and we've leveraged them to appear on our podcast, and we've gotten to a place where we are on the front page of Twitch, and what do we do with it? We zoom in and out of our own dumb place.
I mean, listen, this is the role we were born to play. All right. Shit, are you ready?
Yeah, no, I'm feeling it. Let's do it.
All right, let's go over here, click a button, little whoopsie, little do, the two with the aught fee.
Yeah, by the way, everybody who's new, we do a show, it's called Night Attack. We're about to start it right now. Congratulations. I wish I was you, because if I was you, I would get to see me looking good like this.